Usage Scenario 2, Two-Layer Network with IP Surveillance Solution. In the following slides, we will introduce the second usage scenario and talk about how to implement and configure Usage Scenario 2 Auto Surveillance Network. Usage Scenario 2 is a two-layer switched network with the Smart 3 switch as the core layer switch and two unmanaged switches as the access layer switches as shown in the diagram. In addition, similar to Usage Scenario 1, we have an existing DHCP server, a VMS client, network cameras, and an NVR or VMS server. Here we use the VMS server. The office network with user computers connects to one of the unmanaged switches. This slide shows you the connection ports among the Smart 3 switch, the unmanaged switches, and all of the components. Power on all three switches and connect the unmanaged switch to the Smart 3 switch. Connect D-Link network cameras to the unmanaged switch to the right. Connect the VMS client and the VMS server to the Smart 3 switch. The DHCP server, which currently exists in the user's network environment, has always been connected to the Smart 3 switch and is properly configured by the customer network administrator. Like Usage Scenario 1, you only need to enable the Auto Surveillance VLAN feature. D-Link network cameras are automatically added to Auto Surveillance VLAN with high priority. To record and view videos from the network cameras, we have to add the MAC address of the VMS server to the Smart 3 switch Auto Surveillance VLAN settings. Follow the steps adding user-defined MAC settings we showed you in the Usage Scenario 1. If you want to view VMS server live video or do remote playback, follow the same steps to add the MAC address of the VMS client to the Smart 3 switch Auto Surveillance VLAN settings. After you finish the configuration, both of the VMS server and the client will be recognized by the Smart 3 switch and will be put in the Auto Surveillance VLAN. So let's verify the configuration of the Auto Surveillance VLAN of the Smart 3 switch. As in Scenario 1, open your browser, bring up the Smart 3 switch web management console, and log in to the main page using the default password admin. Skip the Smart Wizard, and in Smart 3 Configuration Console, click Configuration in the left pane and click Auto Surveillance VLAN. In the right pane, you can see that D-Link network cameras, the VMS client, and server have priority settings set to high by default. And the network cameras are recognized by Smart 3 switch as D-Link surveillance device off port 8, VMS server off port 10, and VMS client off port 5, as shown in the Auto Surveillance VLAN summary table. In the above, we introduced the second Auto Surveillance VLAN usage scenario and how you can implement and configure its network.